Hi, my name is Stefan von Alisa, Laser Optics Product Line Manager at Edmund Optics. In this video, we'll discuss specifications to help you determine which laser is correct for your application. The specifications we'll look at are wavelength, coherence length, beam divergence, and Rayleigh range. The wavelength of your laser tells you what spectrum of light you'll be working with. Typically, ultraviolet, visible, or infrared. If you're working with visible light, or 400 nanometers to 700 nanometers, wavelength will also determine what color your laser beam will be. 458 nanometers is blue, 532 nanometers is green, and 632 nanometers is red. Coherence length is the distance over which a laser beam maintains a near constant phase relationship, both temporally and spatially. Simply put, a laser can be considered as a group of collimated photons that are a sinusoidal wave that is in phase. The larger the coherence length of your laser, the closer it is to a perfect sinusoidal wave. However, in the real world, we can't have a perfect electromagnetic wave. An easy way to understand coherence length is to think of it as how much a laser beam deviates from a perfectly sinusoidal wave. Beam divergence describes how much your laser beam diameter increases over a distance. This is an angular measurement, typically given in milliradians, arcseconds, or degrees. A smaller angular value for divergence is desirable, because the smaller the beam divergence, the closer it is to an ideal beam. Inexpensive laser pointers, for example, have higher beam divergence than most gas laser systems that tend to cost much more. The smallest diameter cross-section of your beam is the beam waist. The distance from the beam waist to the place where your cross-sectional area is doubled is called the Rayleigh range. Rayleigh range is an important parameter in lasers that output Gaussian beam profiles. If you are familiar with cameras and imaging lenses, Rayleigh range is roughly the equivalent of depth of field. This is very important in laser cutting and laser welding applications, where a variance in the energy density can have dramatically different effects. To learn more about laser optics, visit our website.